Hey guys, I'm Dov, and today I'm back with more Total War Warhammer 2 multiplayer action. We're here today with a very special replay. This is a replay of Claxton Soothsayer versus Ark in the Black. We've got Dark Elves versus Empire. So let's get straight to it. This is a replay from my son, HW. It's not actually my son, it's just his username. His recent tournament this last weekend. So for those of you guys who are not following him, be sure to give him a follow on Twitch. He does stream some very high level tournaments. This weekend was the playoff, and then this next weekend, I believe, let me just double check that that date here real quick. In fact, October 12th at 7 p.m. Pacific time, the final will be the final stage. So I'll have a link down in the description below to the page there, so you guys can go ahead and give it a follow if you do want to see the finals. So we've got Dark Elves versus Empire here. Let's go ahead and take a look at the builds for the Empire. Starting first, we've got BORIS on a PEGASUS, which is a very interesting choice. Does have very good melee defense with some good debuffs as well. Looking like Amethyst Wizard here. We've got some Spearmen, a couple Demogryph Knights with Halberds here. Interesting infantry line with a couple Archers, one unit of Huntsmen. We've got Gold Chevron, Spearmen with Shields, very strong. A couple Swordsmen as well, a Steam Tank. Interesting choice against the Dark Elves. And you can see he's kind of deployed using the terrain here a little bit. As for the rest of the Dark Elves here, we've got Slaanesh's Harvesters hidden in the woods, a couple units of Dark Riders with crossbows, some Cold One Knights, lots of Sisters of Slaughter and Sisters of Singing Doom in the front line, a couple Dread Spears as well. Looks like, MALEKITH as we saw up on the dragon. Nice, balanced Dark Elf build with some good infantry hitting power, very good against the Empire. I do like the pick of the Veteran Spears as well. You can see up to 52 melee defense. Considering their cost, that is very strong. We come forward with the Fate of Buna against those Sisters of Singing Doom. Interesting choice, specifically on the Sisters, of course, because they do cause terror. That is going to do a lot of HP damage. Probably won't drop many models there, but still, good stuff so far. You can see the Empire player just staying nice and tight here, making sure he keeps it up his defensive position. But interesting stuff so far. These Demogryph Knights, it's going to be a little bit interesting. Having them deployed this close to the edge of the map means that if anything goes wrong and they get routed off, it's going to be a big problem. But Sisters of Singing Doom, you can see, did drop less than 10 unit models there. But the cannon from the steam tank now firing in. If we have a look, the infantry fight getting underway, some Red Spears clashing. A very nice Gaze of Malice there from MALEKITH. And the steam tank holding firm. The swordsmen will be able to stand for the time being. And the Sisters of Singing Doom will get in here. A little bit of friendly fire, though, from those Dark Riders. And I can't imagine those Sisters will stay for too long. Yeah, steam tank immediately running forward, running them over. Over on the far side, we've got an interesting engagement. Demogryph Knights with Halberds going to get in and get on these Slaanesh's Harvesters. That being said, they did get the Word of Pain on them, significantly debuffing their melee attack. Looks like MALEKITH drops down. BORIS also going to drop down, sort of VTOLing in on his Pegasus. A little bit of an awkward charge there, but yeah, BORIS again, because of that really, really nice regeneration and the good melee defense, will be able to hold reasonably well in this combat. The Demogryph Knights are just getting absolutely owned here, though, because of that Word of Pain. They're really not paying out much value. We've also got Sisters of Slaughter supporting in here. Stand your ground for the Dark Elves, significantly buffing their melee defense as well, so they're going to take very few hits. Over here, these Demogryph Knights with Halberds getting swamped by Cold One Knights. They're not going to trade super efficiently into those Cold One Knights, especially with the Dark Riders pouring in some Overwatch fire there. These Archers providing a little bit of Overwatch into Sisters of Slaughter. This is great, great value here. Oh, nope, looks like they're going to turn and maybe shoot at those Dark Riders instead. The Dark Riders are a little bit kind of up against this terrain feature here, so they can't flee away too far, but yeah, looks like actually the bows being used on the Cold One Knights there, which is a little bit of a mistake in my opinion. There's a lot of high value, low armor targets that he could be shooting at, getting a lot better value there, but the blob fight's definitely getting underway. BORIS, though, up in the air, challenging MALEKITH is pretty risky, but BORIS, again, because of that high melee defense, is probably going to be able to hold up okay. Only 50 attack, or 54 attack on MALEKITH, 55 defense for BORIS, so he actually will hold up reasonably well in a dual situation there. Infantry fight, though, not going great for the Empire. We do still have a few units of swordsmen going to get hit by a really nice Gaze of Malice here. Oh man, just rips apart the unit. The Sisters of Slaughter going to go ahead and detach, getting to a supporting position here. Try and help route off some of these Empire infantry so that MALEKITH can start to focus BORIS a little bit more effectively. The back line here, Dark Elves are getting in with the Doomfire Warlock's gonna get in here, get some really nice splash attacks on these archers, start to take out those ranged units. Even though they are very cheap, they can generate really nice value. A Dark Rider's sitting back in a commanding position as well. Things are not looking great for the Empire, but of course, balance of power is still very even. They were able to get some Demigryph Knights back on the field here. These swordsmen not doing the greatest job screening. They probably could chase those Dark Riders a little bit there, but the Steam Tank also very healthy at this point. Looks like we're gonna have a Soul Stealer though on the Steam Tank, and those Demigryph Knights also did get hit by that, so that should be enough to rout them off. We'll do some damage to the Steam Tank as well, and critically is gonna be healing Malekith as he gets into an interesting situation with BORIS here. BORIS gonna pop that Foe Seeker, and the two of them are gonna duel up in the air, and this is what I'm talking about. Because of BORIS's good stats here, I mean, 60 attack, 55 defense on the Pegasus is much better. We'll have to compare versus on a Griffin, but I do believe this is the reason you bring him on the Pegasus, because that's just great combat stats for a heroic character in the air. 80 charge as well, super fast with 131 speed with that that Foe Seeker active, and you can see with the Spirit Leech especially, he's actually winning against Malekith here. So Word of Pain gonna go down there. BORIS, of course, very low on melee attack, but still has that good 55 melee defense, especially with Hold the Line. Unfortunately, his ground force is getting cleaned up pretty bad. If we take an overarching look here, you can see Sisters of Slaughter moving in on those veteran spears to clean them up. They had been winning out okay. Archer's gonna get some okay fire into those Dark Riders, but the Cav for the Dark Elves has just been able to clean up a lot of these lighter Empire units. Amethyst Wizard enraged by the Sisters of Singing Doom, so he can no longer throw Spirit Leeches at Malekith. The Steam Tank, though, is in a position to support. Honestly, might want to pull back, try and shoot a cannon shot through the side of this unit, and then charge in for a big terror route. But yeah, Swordsman again going to get caught up by Sisters of Slaughter here. The rest of the Empire units getting chased off here, and it does look like the Slaanesh's Harvesters still have quite a bit left in the tank, so not looking great for the Empire. Still reasonably even on the balance of power, but some really bad situations, as we do have some Swordsmen coming back here. They're just, you know, these isolated pockets are not looking the best, and BORIS gonna get a little bit surrounded here potentially. Looks like he may be able to get up and away. If BORIS can actually get in here and finish Malekith off, then the Dark Elves are gonna have big issues taking on the Steam Tank. They won't be able to kill it in the late game, and it should be able to just, I mean, maybe the Dark Riders could finish it off. They do still have quite a bit of ammo, but it is gonna be a big, big pain to deal with. Of course, the Steam Tank can shoot back with that that big anti-cav type projectile, but yeah, here comes BORIS. It's a bit risky with the Dark Riders in a supporting position. You can see they're both able to fire in at the back of BORIS. It looks like they may instead go after the Steam Tank. I'm not sure here, but Malekith lands on the Shattered Spearmen. This is to try and pull BORIS down onto the ground so that he can get the support of these Cold One Knights here, in a very veteran play from Thlaxton Soothsayer. He is able to catch BORIS on the ground here, so a big mistake by the Empire player. Definitely wanted to peel BORIS off, keep him up in the air, and maybe come help protect the Steam Tank a little bit. But Steam Tank, definitely want to be focusing on those Dark Riders. Some beautiful hits there on those units, but BORIS is in huge trouble as Malekith's able to catch him on the ground with the support of the Cold One Knights. This fight will absolutely turn against BORIS. You can see him starting to take some chunks of damage, gets terrified there, and that should pretty much be the back-breaking blow. The Steam Tank able to continue to shoot at these Dark Riders a little bit. They're going to start to use up the rest of their ammo. And Malekith's pretty low. I don't know if he's for sure going to be able to finish off this Steam Tank. But with BORIS going down, it's definitely going to be a tough late game situation. The Sisters of Slaughter will get in here and start to apply some poison on the Steam Tank, just to debuff its stats a little bit there. A nice Gaze of Malice going to just wreck what's left of those Empire State Troops. And yeah, balance of power turning pretty decisively at this point as BORIS does get chased off. Looks like Arkhan's going to go ahead and throw in the towel there. He may be able to have pulled it out in the late game with that Steam Tank, but it's pretty unlikely. So, very interesting builds on both sides. I'd quite like the pick of BORIS on the Pegasus there. I had not considered that his combat stats were so strong. We'll go ahead and take a look at that in just a moment, but as for Malekith himself, 68 kills, very good stuff, obviously. Infantry doing reasonably well, especially the Sisters of Slaughter, obviously mopping up a lot of Empire State Troops, 169, 126. Going this Cav heavy is also pretty decent against the Empire as well. A little bit of a narrow build in my opinion, but at the same time, he definitely had quite a bit of tools here. The Cold One Knights did a good job, Malekith able to rack up quite a few kills as well. For the Empire side, I do think that the Demigryph Knights with Halberds were a little bit of a mistake here. Personally, I would only really take the Royal Alt of Griffites, but generally I would say you're better off to maybe downgrade these guys to Reichsguard, just to give you a way to hold, and then try and give you something else to actually kill the Cold One Knights. You know, like maybe just focusing on Spirit Leech with your Deathcaster here, or, you know, there's some other things you could do, try and get some armor-piercing missiles, or maybe even just like a debuff, like even if you just throw Accusation on the Cold One Knights and then have the Reichsguard charge them, the Reichsguard will do well enough to, especially on the charge with that debuff, the armor and the melee defense debuff and everything, Reichsguard will do well enough that they should be able to win out against those Cold One Knights, and then you can use them to obviously clean up infantry a lot more effectively. Also, just being able to go a bit wider here, I think, is a little bit better. I mean, obviously, the steam tank's very expensive, so I think maybe you just cheap out, and you could even go with, like, I don't know if you could quite afford 4 units of Empire Knights if you cut both of these. I guess, what is that? 3,000? So, yeah, you couldn't quite afford 4? Well, am I mathing this out right? Let's go ahead and have a look. So, if we check a couple things here, let's just go over to the Empire. And, yeah, so for the price of 2 Demigryph Knights with Halberds, I guess we could come in here and grab, let's see. Yeah, not quite, but just in general, I think even just going with, like, the Reichsguard and the Zintler's Reichsguard especially with that good melee defense, good charge bonus, maybe with the funds you save there, you can go afford to bring a Witch Hunter here with just the Accusation that will debuff the melee defense and armor of those Cold One Knights, and should mean that the Reichsguard will win that fight pretty decisively. I don't know, maybe not super decisively, but likewise, the missile attack is good for just side-shotting through Dark Elf infantry and so on. Can be a little bit tricky, but I definitely think that that would have been a better option for a cavalry selection. Alternately, you could just go a bit wider. As you guys know as well, I'm a big fan of Pistoliers in this matchup. They do a ton of missile damage to light armor units, and just in general, can help give you, again, a little bit more of a wider build, because, I mean, Flaxen Soothsayer's build was relatively narrow there. It didn't have that many units. I mean, it had, what, maybe, like, 15 units? So if you brought, like, a full 20 stack, you know, you're just going to be able to kind of dictate the pace of the battle a little bit in that you just have more troops. You can kind of throw different things in different directions and kind of get some more favorable situations. It's interesting. Empire versus Dark Elves is one of the most interesting matchups. And just from an Empire player's perspective, there's 1,000 different ways that both factions can go. So it's definitely pretty interesting. Hopefully you guys enjoyed watching this one. Just quickly, I guess, before we wanted to end, I wanted to check Boris's stats. I mean, yeah, if you look, Griffins tend to have pretty poor melee defense in general. 38 for Carl. Boris on the Griffin has only 35, but again, on the Pegasus, 50 melee defense is quite good, and considering that he also had that hold the line for an additional 5, and yeah, it's a quite tanky character considering how fast he is, and he hits reasonably hard as well. 430 weapon strength is pretty decent, not the best AP values in the world, but 80 charge bonus, certainly very strong. 60 melee attack as well. I'll have to try out this Boris on a Pegasus a little bit more often, just because he does look like a pretty powerful combatant in this form. So yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed watching. If you do like this sort of content, be sure to like, subscribe, hit that bell notification button, so every time I upload a new video, you'll be notified. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time.